cheated, but still to come up tonight, Bubba Ray Dudley and Hardcore Holly collide in this great singles matchup. But will it truly be one-on-one, Cole?
You know what cool is? You're looking at it. Cool is what you make it. And there's no pool like Caribbean pool. But some people don't want to be cool. Like this guy. And I spit in the face of people who don't want to be cool. Viejo desgraciado. So when I come to the WWE, you better be cool. Cool like me. Carlito. Caribbean.
That guy looks like the guy from American Idol.
Yeah, Brian Seacrest.
Seems to be a real friendly guy, though. Carlito Cool.
It's good music.
Well, here comes the reflection of perfection.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall, approaching the ring from Atlanta, Georgia, weighing in at 263 pounds, the reflection of perfection, Mark Jindrak.
What happened to the robe? The cape of conceit?
Right.
I think Mark Jindrak's too tired of covering up his body. You see how he looks at himself, then looks at the people like they don't deserve to see him, and right there, it's just the people don't deserve it. But here's Abacus, Cole. Abacus is the mirror. How do you know this stuff? This is my job, Velocity. I follow up. I'm a fountain of misinformation. Wait a minute. I'm a fountain of information.
Right.
Just misunderstood.
I like the first one better.
Thank you.
And from Japan, weighing in at 208 pounds, Funaki.
Well, the more things change, the more things remain the same on Velocity. Here comes Funaki, set to go one-on-one with Mark Jindrak.
Now, Funaki could now become the number one announcer again, being that my partner, Josh, is incapacitated.
Yeah, at the hands of Heidenreich.
Like Funaki doesn't even live in Japan.
No, he lives in San Antonio, Texas. Imagine Funaki with a cowboy hat riding a horse.
Funaki on a horse.
And by the way, big happy birthday goes out to Sho Funaki this week.
42 years old.
No.
Well, in yen, if you translate, he's like 35.
Oh, okay. And Jindrak, really, telling Funaki that he shouldn't even be in the ring with him because he's perfection and Funaki isn't. It's a nice way to talk to your opponent.
Well, if you're going to yell at him, try to make it mean something. See, Heidenreich, he got upset. Maybe Funaki gets upset right now and knocks the wind out of Mark Jindrak.
I told you. You understand?
And maybe not.
Oh, missed with the left hand. Funaki ducks underneath the leg away by Funaki to Mark Jindrak. Funaki firing up here. Whipped into the corner. Here comes Mark Jindrak. Nobody home. And Funaki, great deep arm drag. And another deep arm drag. And Funaki, the veteran, taking it to Jindrak, or he was momentarily.
One too many arm drags for Sho Funaki.
You got your tickets yet?
Four.
Your plane tickets to Sacramento for SmackDown this week.
I'm not sure if I'm going. I'm going to see what Josh is doing.
Oh, you'll be there. You're not going to want to miss Kurt Angle and Eddie Guerrero. Best two out of three falls.
What have the last six matches been?
Eddie Guerrero won at WrestleMania. Kurt Angle won at SummerSlam. This is the rubber match, so to speak.
Are they going to shake hands again? Because if they're going to shake hands, I'm going to tell you what. I'm not really too interested.
Hey, after Kurt Angle destroyed Eddie's lowrider, and then Eddie was escorted from the building after inadvertently destroying GM Teddy Long's car, I don't think there's going to be any handshaking between Angle and Guerrero.
So this whole thing comes back around again because Eddie Guerrero accidentally banged up Theodore Long's nice ride.
Right, but Kurt Angle did not accidentally spill paint on Eddie's lowrider. Let's not forget about that. Wow! Great vertical leap, hook of the leg, shoulders down, kick out.
Then how come Kurt Angle wasn't thrown out of the arena when Theodore Long knew that Kurt Angle baited Eddie Guerrero?
Because Theodore Long wanted to make sure the ratings were good for SmackDown, so he put Kurt Angle in a match against Rey Mysterio.
Wow. Come on. See, this is a different side of things.
Right.
You should be here every week.
Because general manager Theodore Long is not only concerned about, you know, putting great matches on the air, but he's also concerned about how many great wrestling fans get the opportunity to watch SmackDown every week.
So you're saying right now that Kurt Angle and Rey Mysterio was the best we could do?
One of the best.
I agree.
Undertaker and Orlando Jordan for the WWE title. That story's coming up as well. That happened this past week.
Theodore Long's just got a bad attitude in a short amount of time.
Well, would you if some guy beat up your 1989 Signature Series Lincoln?
I wasn't even driving in 1989.
Yes. 1989? You were 35.
Yeah, but I lost my license, so I wasn't even driving.
And look at Funaki with a right hand to the side of the head of Mark Kidrack. Funaki taking it to the reflection of perfection.
I told you.
And he's still talking to Funaki.
Yeah, and he's still getting his rear end kicked.
This match should have been over with that tremendous left
hand. It may be over now.
That left-handed chin drag, but he gives Funaki every opportunity to sneak one over.
Oh, speaking of being over, velocity isn't over yet, is it?
Heck no, we got a lot more to
come. Funaki hook of the leg. Kick out by chin drag. Still got that tough enough information coming up following this matchup.
See, you can't leave that alone, can you?
All you guys over the age of 20, get ready. Have your pen and paper ready. Right hand by Funaki. Ducks underneath. Mark Jindrak, there is the arm of excellence. Jindrak wins. Great effort by Funaki.
And Jindrak's still won.
Jindrak picks up the victory over Funaki. Great effort by Funaki, but Mark Jindrak telling Funaki, I told you so. Coming up, information time. Get your pen and paper ready. All you guys over the age of 20, all you have to do is send us a one-minute VHS of yourself showing us why you should be on the $1 Million Tough It Up. Send those